Hello designers, welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create a pear. So we'll go from this on the left hand side, bunch of shapes, to this which looks like a pear now, and adding the color so you end up with this. Let's get into it. Okay, let's go ahead and make this pear. So you can probably see I've got a few colors that I've just placed there. These are the colors that I want to use when creating the pear. You can choose whichever color you want. So to begin with, let me show you my document setup in case you're wondering. It's the same it always is, 1920 by 1080 pixels. I'm going to go ahead and select snapping, toggle that on. If you want to see my settings, there they are. Not that important, but at the start, we're going to do a little bit of aligning with the snapping tools. Okay, the first thing you need is the ellipse tool. Go ahead and click on that. It's the round circle, basically. And then you're just going to hold down shift, command, click, and drag. That's just to keep it in proportion and drag from the center there. Now I'm going to click on V, the move tool, and I'm just going to position it somewhere like this, maybe. And I'm going to choose a color. So the first thing I'm going to do is go up to my color tab up there. And I don't want to have to keep going over there to select it. So I'm just going to drag it out, maybe somewhere like that. And I'll just make it slightly smaller as well. Look, you can resize these boxes. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to the fill and select none. I'm going to go to the stroke, that's the donut, and I'm just going to make sure it's black. The next thing I'm going to do is change the width of our stroke because you can't really see it right now. So up to the stroke width up here. Just click and drag that till it gets to somewhere like 8.5 and we're ready to get started. By the way, just quick shortcut, if you want to increase or decrease the stroke width, that's our black outline, you can just press the left or right bracket key. So like this. Okay, so we have our circle. Let's go ahead and duplicate it. So I'm going to hold down command, shift, click and drag. That's made a duplicate and I'm just going to scale it down somewhat. So I'm just going to hold the same shortcuts again, shift, command, click from the corner and drag. I'll drag it somewhere like this. And I'm just going to click and drag that down to stretch it out and just push that up a little bit like that. And you see the snapping is coming in useful here because I can center it. You see that green line? That's why the snapping is working for us, okay? You see these two nodes here? I'm making sure that they are within the circle shape, and that's going to help us when we start using our next tool, which is the corner tool, okay? So what you want to do now is add both of these shapes together. So I'm going to select both of them, look over in the layers panel, these two layers here. You can select both of them from here by just simply dragging out and selecting both of them, or you could just click on one, hold shift, and click on the other one. So both of them are selected now. We're going to add them together by going up to Boolean operations and we're going to click add. So now they are just one shape, okay? And if I go to my layers panel here, I can just name it pear shape and press return. It's time to use the corner tool. So head on up to the corner tool or press C on the keyboard, click on it. And you see these two nodes here? I'm going to click and drag. So it's selected both of them. And I'm just going to click on one of them and drag out like this. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. I'm going to go ahead and click on Bake Appearance. So this is our pear shape. It's one of those fat ones. So before I go ahead and start adding color, I'm just going to create the other things. So we're going to need a stalk and we're going to need a leaf. So we'll start off with the stalk. So head on over to the left-hand side again, click on the rectangle tool, and then just click and drag out a rectangle like this. In fact, I no longer need snapping on anymore. So I could just click on that. And we're going to go in, I'll press the move tool, which is V, and I'm just going to center it by eye. I don't really care that much. And maybe I'll drag it out to about here. And now I'm going to go up to convert to curves because I want to further play with this. So I press convert to curves and now I can see the nodes and I'm automatically in the node tool because it knows that I want to play with it. So I'm just going to drag this one down like this. And I'm going to drag that out a little bit. And in fact, I'll drag that out as well. And I'll just click on this line and just drag it up ever so slightly like this. And I will drag this one in as well. So this is our stalk, still looking a bit thick. I could probably move that in a bit. Yeah, that'll do for now. So I'll just press V, center it a little bit more. That's our stalk complete. Let's create our leaf. And a quick way to do this is just to go ahead and click on the triangle tool. Let's click and drag out something like this and we'll click on convert to curves. Okay, so now we can see the nodes. So what we're going to do is just click and drag that down. That's the bottom of our leaf And then we're going to drag that across like that. And now we're going to convert this node to a smooth node. So we can go up here to convert to smooth. And we can drag this out a little bit. And you see the path here? If I just click on that and drag it in, you see it creates this handle. So I'll just drag it somewhere like that. And now I can just start playing with this handle here. So it looks a little bit more like a leaf. So that is our leaf. Excellent. We'll continue working on that later. The only other thing I need is something to cover this area here. There's usually like a little lip there hiding it. So I'm going to go ahead and click on our shapes again. And I'm going to go down to crescent tool. And I'm going to click and drag out a shape like this. And I'm going to drag the handle across, just rotate it. And right now, actually, I don't need a stroke on that. So I'm going to go up to our colors here. And I'm just going to click no stroke. Go to fill, make it all black. Now I can just click on V, the move tool, and just drag it up till it kind of hides that there. We can play around with that more later on, but this is our outline done. We're ready to move forward. Okay, what we're going to do now is just label our layers because it can get confusing as we start creating more. So let's go ahead and click on the stalk over there. And I'll just double click in the layers panel and just call it stalk. And I'll just keep going up, naming each of them. So that's our leaf. And this one here, what should I call this actually? I'll just call it lip. There we go. Okay, let's just drag that there and we'll place our color maybe over there. So everything's laid out a little bit better. So we'll start on the stalk. We'll start adding color to this. So I've selected it. Now I can go over to the color. You see this color picker tool here. I can click and drag that. And I want to make this dark here. So I'm just selecting our color down there and I'll let go. This little color well, I've heard that's actually what it's called, the color well. I'm going to click on that and it applies it to our stalk. So I'm just going to zoom in on this. What I want to do is one part is a shadow and then on the left hand side, it might be a little bit lighter. So what I'm going to do is just make a copy of it. So I'm going to press Command C, Command V. I've got a complete copy now. You see like over there. And now I'm just going to click on the stroke, set stroke to none. And I'm going to go on the fill and I'm just going to go ahead and select this color down here. So color picker tool, hover over that and click. And now it's changed the color of it. Okay. So if we click on the node tool, which is A, I can start playing around with these here. And you see right now it's going beyond the lines underneath. So what I can do here is clip it inside of the shape below. So if we go down to our stalk there, this is the lighter version, click on it and just drag it on top of that layer there. Now you see it's all being hidden underneath. So I'll just play around with this until I've got the right amount of highlight. So this will be our highlight on the left-hand side. That will be our shadow. That's pretty much done. So let's go ahead and apply some color to the actual pear. So I've selected it now. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and click on the color picker tool and I'll just go down to this darker green version here. Click on the color well and it's applied it. So we want to make this a little bit more three-dimensional. We're not going to go for any fades or anything too fancy. We're just going to be working with flat layers. So if I click on V, the move tool, our pear shape is selected. We're going to make a copy of it. So Command C, Command V. In the layers panel, you can see we have two copies now. So I'll just name the copy pear highlight. And I'll change the color of it. So I'm going to go up to the color picker tool again, click on that, and I'll choose the slightly lighter green. Click on the color well to apply, and there we go. Don't worry, our darker green is hiding behind. But right now we need to get rid of this black stroke here. So I'm going to set stroke to none. So as you can see, we have a light version of it. What we want to do next is clip it inside of this shape here. So I'll just press Command Z so it goes back to where it should be. Over to the layers panel again, click on it. Drag it on top of the darker layer there, and now it's inside. So see the layers panel? If I click on this, I click on the pear highlight, I can drag it around inside of it. So we want the right-hand side to have shadow. So I'll probably leave it around about here, and I'll just drag that down a little bit like this, and maybe across. There we go. And now I want to make another duplicate and make it slightly lighter. So I'm going to press Command C, Command V. I've got a new duplicate. I'm going to change the color of it. So I'll just make sure fill is selected. Grab the color picker tool and choose the lighter green color. And I'll click on the color well to apply. Okay, now we can just click on one of the corners here and just drag it down like this. Also, you could press on the contour tool. So up here is the contour tool, or you can press O on the keyboard. And then you could just click and drag. And you see that? It offsets the path slightly like this. Quite nice, actually. It's working well, so we will use this. Once that's done, I want to bake that look in so I can maybe further play with the nodes. So I'm going to go up to Bake Appearance, click on that. Now I'll click on the Move tool, just so we can move it over a little bit like this. And I'll leave it around there for now. So the next thing I want to do is create a highlight for this edge over here. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to select this layer down here, and I'm going to make a duplicate of this. So Command C, Command V. And I'll just change the color of it to just blue for now, just so it's super obvious which one it is. And I'll just move it back into the center there. And I'll make another duplicate now. So Command C, Command V again. This time I'll choose another really odd color. And I'll just click and drag it across like this. You see the blue in the background, it's just kind of peeking through. That's what we want for the highlight. And I'll just size that up slightly. So now all I need to do is use this orange pear layer to cut into the blue pear layer. So if it's more obvious for you, I'll do it from the layers panel. I will hold shift and click on the blue pear. So both of them are selected. I'm going to go up to Boolean operations, and I'm just going to select subtract. And you see now we only have that blue slither left. So now I can give it the color I actually wanted to give it. So color picker tool again. And I'll drag it onto the lightest green color we have, click on the color well, and there we go. See, we have that little highlight there. We can go ahead and play around with any of these a little bit more by just selecting them and just pressing on the node tool. So you see up here, I don't want it to be like this. I'd like it to be a little bit more like this. And in fact, I could probably move that up a little bit just so it's a lot smoother. And I could probably move this down slightly as well. Okay, let's go ahead and work on the leaf. I'll go ahead and select it, and we'll choose a color for it. So I will choose the lightest color first. So I'll just click on the color well again, and I've applied that lightest green look to it. And before I do anything else, I'm going to press V. I'll make a duplicate of this. So Command C, Command V, made a duplicate just here, you see. And I'm going to get rid of the stroke. So click on the stroke and set fill to none. Click on the fill. And now I'm going to select this dark green here and just apply it. Okay, so I'm going to make sure that that's inside. So I'll just hover it over like this, and I'll go over to my layers panel, and I will clip it inside like that and let go. So I just want a portion of it, the top part, to be showing just like that. And I'll click on the node tool and just drag that up slightly like this. There we go. So we have our little highlight there. So I just want to add two more layers to this. Okay. So the first one being that central line you might see in a leaf, and then I'll add another color. So I'll click on the pen tool over on the left-hand side, select that, and I'll just click once here, click once, click and drag out a little bit like this. And I'll click once more and click and drag. Now I'll use the node tool to play around with it slightly more. Let's make it black actually, so we can see what we're doing. So over to the color, set fill to none, go to the stroke, make it black. Now let's play around with it slightly. There we go. So I just want to make this end here pointy. So a quick way to do that is to use the width tool. So over there on the left-hand side, you see stroke width tool. You can click on that, or you can click on W on your keyboard. That's the shortcut. And I'll just click somewhere like this and just click and drag that little handle down. Now it's a nice smooth ending there, a nice pointy one. So now I'm going to click on V. And in fact, I think this should be applied to the other side. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select all of those layers that I've just created, and I'm going to drag it onto this side here. And I'm going to use the transform panel option called flip horizontal. So click on that. And now I can rotate this slightly and just drag it to over here. I do want this central point here. I want this to come out and actually touch this stalk here. So I'm going to click on our little curve and click and drag it outside of the leaf so it's not clipped inside. And I'll just rejig that there. And let's have a look at it. I'll just do a couple more things. I think this leaf is actually quite small. So I'm going to select all of that there. And I'm just going to scale it up. So I'll just hold down shift, click on one of the corners there, and scale it up so it's a lot bigger. Let's have a look at that size. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. And I could probably rotate it a little bit more. And now I'll just click on just this line here, click on the node tool, put it somewhere like that. Yep, all looking quite good there. In fact, I'll add one more color here, just a little dark patch. So I'll just click once here and I'll click on the pen tool or P on the keyboard. And I'll just start drawing out some kind of shape. So click. There we go. I'll just choose a different color because I don't want it to be a stroke. So set stroke to none, click on the fill, and I'll just go down color picker tool, select the darkest green, click on the color well, and make further amendments if I need to. So click on the node tool and I'll just play around with these handles until I'm happy. And I'll just drag this layer. See in the layers panel, just drag it up because it went inside of the leaf there. And just play around with that ever so slightly. All right, there we go. That is our pear and the leaf. And it's looking okay, isn't it? Very quick to do this. And of course, if you wanted to further customize it, you know, of course you can use effects. So I could select that in the middle there, go down to effects, and let's go ahead and select Gaussian blur. And I could just click and drag this up. And you see it gives it more of a gradual kind of highlight there, but this isn't that kind of design. So I'll unselect that and press close. One final thing I want to do, I just drag this back up here. One final thing I want to do is just add a background just so it looks cool. And this will be my way of going some way to creating my thumbnail for this video. So I'll go ahead and click on snapping and I'll just click and drag out till it snaps into place there. Click on the move tool. Obviously it's right on top right now. Quick way to drag it from the top of the layer stack to the bottom is just to hold down Shift, Command, and left bracket key. Now that's sent that layer all the way to the back there. And I'll choose some kind of color that's going to work for it. Yeah, maybe this color here will do. And there we go. It's done. Okay, let's do a little test. If I select all of it and then I scale it down, is it going to look the same? No, it isn't. You see that? It's not looking the same. You know why? Because you have to go to stroke and then see scale with object. If I click on that, and then I try and scale all of those layers down again. See when I zoom in, it looks exactly the same. So if you ever come into that issue, it's because of that, okay? Scale with object, that's under the stroke tab, very useful. And that marks the end of this tutorial. If you liked it, let me know in the comments section. If you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and subscribe. And if you want to see more Affinity Designer tutorials, then go ahead and check out the rest of my channel. I've got plenty of them. I'm just making a few duplicates here. Command J. And let's put it to about here. And I just press Command J again. Anyway, that's it for this tutorial. Catch you on the next video.